Hey everybody, happy Tuesday. We are here for night two of our devotional this week, and tonight's devotional is Get in the Game. So if you were at VBS last year, we know all about getting in the game, huh? But let's learn a little bit more. Let's pray and we'll get started. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this day. Lord, I thank you for each and every person that will watch this video. Lord, I pray that your word just come to us through this devotional. And it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So, get in the game. How are we going to get in the game tonight? So, fear can keep us from getting hurt. A good, healthy fear of falling can help us from standing too close to a dangerous ledge. So we're not going to stand on the edge of Mount Pleasant, right? Fear can also keep us from experiencing good things, like learning to skate or ride a bike or even share our faith. God wants us to get in the game. He wants us to give our fears to Him so that fear cannot stand in the way of us living the life He wants for us. So you know what's next. It's question time. Have you ever had a fear that you were able to overcome? Looking back, how did you feel about that fear you once had? Did you think it was silly after you were able to overcome it? Is there something that scares you about serving God? Take a few minutes and talk to your parents about those questions and share with them, okay? So fear can prevent us from experiencing God's blessings. Fear kept the Israelites who left Egypt from entering the land God promised to them. Instead of focusing on God's promises, they focused on the dangers that lay ahead. So we're going to turn in our Bibles. We're going to Numbers chapter 13. We're going to start in verse 26, but we're going to go to chapter 14, verse 4, okay? So Numbers chapter 13, starting in verse 26. Let's read. The men went back to Moses, Aaron, and the entire Israelite community in the wilderness of Paran at Kadesh. They brought back a report for them and the whole community, and they showed them the fruit of the land. They reported to Moses, "We went into the land where you sent us. Indeed, it is flowing with milk and honey, and here is some of its fruit. However, the people living in the land are strong, and the cities are large and fortified. We also saw the descendants of Anak there. The Amalekites are living in the land of Negev. The Hittites, Jebusites, and Amorites live in the hill country, and the Canaanites live by the sea and along the Jordan." Then Caleb quieted the people in the presence of Moses and said, "We must go up and take possession of the land, because we can certainly conquer it." But the men who had gone up with him responded, "We can't go up against the people, because they are stronger than we are." So they gave a negative report to the Israelites about the land they had scouted. "The land we pass through to explore is one that devours its inhabitants, and all the people we saw in it are men of great size. We even saw the Nephilim there. The descendants of Anak come from the Nephilim. To ourselves we seemed like grasshoppers, and we must have seemed the same to them." Then the whole community broke into loud cries, and the people wept that night. All the Israelites complained about Moses and Aaron, and the whole community told them, "If only we had died in the land of Egypt, or if only we had died in this wilderness. Why is the Lord bringing us into this land to die by the sword? Our wives and little children will become plunder. Wouldn't it be better for us to go back to Egypt?" So they said to one another, "Let's appoint a leader and go back to Egypt." So Caleb and Joshua were the only two adults who made it all the way from Egypt to the promised land because they refused to let fear hold them back. They got in the game and they enjoyed the blessings of the Lord. So what are some steps that you can take? So is there a new kid that you haven't made friends with at school or in your neighborhood? Well, obviously, we're not going to school right now. But is there a new kid that maybe moved into your neighborhood? The next time you see them, when it's safe, go up and say hello. Is there someone that you want to invite to church? Maybe you can send them a letter. Even though we're only meeting online right now, you guys can still invite people to watch church with you. Go ahead and invite them. Don't let the fear keep you from enjoying God's blessings and doing the good work He has created you to do. So guys, even though life looks a little different right now, we're watching church maybe on our computers or our laptops or our TVs, our tablets, whatever you have to watch church on, guys, you can still invite your friends to church. Send them an email, message them via Facebook or Zoom, however your parents will let you get a hold of them. And I'm sure that if you're wanting to invite them to church, that they will help you get a hold of your friends. All right, guys, I love you, and I'll see you tomorrow.